And look at that, it actually washes it down. Nice. Hello and welcome back to Speed Freak Garage, home of PowerSports on YouTube. So today we are going to show you a better way to clean the chip tray in your Tormach 1100MX. At the end of each workday, I clean off the table with a T-slot cleaner, and then I take a brush and I brush off the accordion covers. And normally I will also take the brush and brush the chip tray and the walls down. However, that's extremely tedious, and when you lean in, you get chips all over. Like, you can see there's chips in my skin just from reaching in to install this new line. So I needed a better way. And so I just stole an idea from my day job, basically, because in my day job, they use something sort of kind of similar, more professional, but this is a quick... Anyway, what I did is I took two VR cable retractors, link in the description below, and then I took a pneumatic half-inch airline kit with some connectors and valves, link also in the description below, and I hooked it up in a way that it holds the line out of my way. I can leave my coolant on and shut the line off, or I can shut the coolant off and turn the line on. And obviously you wouldn't want both of those shut off because that would be a bad day. And just to show you that this is not going to interfere, so if I come down, the VR cable retractors very expertly, almost got my vise, very expertly hold everything out of the way and back away from the mill, so there won't be any wrapping your pneumatic line around an end mill, which would also be a bad day. Now, for those of you who don't, maybe you're just gotten started in milling and you don't really know, so your coolant has oil in it. And when the coolant dries, it leaves a thin film of oil, which prevents your table from rusting, it prevents your vise from rusting, it prevents things from getting nasty in here. And so if you wash down all of this with coolant, it actually helps prevent your chip tray from rusting, especially the sections of the chip tray that don't really usually get coolant because they're high up. So this should work really well. And if it doesn't, then it's on video that I screwed up. But I'm pretty confident this is gonna wash. Maybe not these really big clumps, because they're pretty heavy clumps, and I purposefully left an entire week's worth of work in here just to kind of demonstrate. Sorry, too much talking. So first I'll just show you, my coolant works just fine still. No leaks, you know, the fitting's good, it's dry, we're not getting any drips. No pressure problems there. And now I have this reducer nozzle, also link in the description below, to try and get a little more pressure out of this washdown. I might not need this, I'm gonna start with it. So we're going to turn this off and this on, and then I'm gonna grab a hold of it, because, yeah. Gotta hold your hose before you start going. Come on. That's kind of pathetic, actually. But that's actually really pathetic. But you can see I can now... Yeah, that's odd. It's not like near as strong of a flow as I would have expected coming from... That's not really doing the best job. This isn't working. I mean, it would work if there wasn't a bunch of clumps, but it's not really doing what I expected. Not even close. Okay, we're gonna just shove this little line in here and hope that gives us a little more pressure and or velocity. Ooh. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. That would help if I wasn't stupid. Ooh. Ooh, better. Better. That's better. That's way better. Look at that. Okay. I'm just gonna like create a simulated mess here. Come on. Okay. And look at that. It actually washes it down. Nice. Alright, so I think this will work. I'm happier now. Well, okay, maybe I spoke too soon. Still doesn't like big clumps. I really, really need a higher horsepower motor, honestly. I think it's an eighth horsepower, a quarter horse would have been like perfect for this machine. I don't know how I'd even upgrade that without a lot of trouble, because they kind of jammed it in there. Alright, that's the video. Sorry if it was disappointing. Yeah, I'm disappointed. That's life. See you guys next time.